So let us start. So I welcome everybody for today's webinar. So today's topic is regarding to SolidWorks Plastics, how we can leverage this software to design our plastic parts easily, and also keeping in mind the manufacturing point of view that it can be easily manufactured without any defects. So I hope I'm clearly audible and my screen is clearly visible to you. So let me start. Myself Gaurav Harne, I am working as an application engineer here at Engineering Technique, and I handle the products like SolidWorks CAD, including SolidWorks Simulation, SolidWorks Flow Simulation, that is CFD, as well as SolidWorks Plastics, which is our injection molding machine method. So the agenda that we will be following today will cover topics like injection molding overview. So I will just take you through a quick brief that what is the injection molding, as well as what are the plastic materials, also the common defects in injection molded parts that we usually come across and that we have to avoid. Then we will take a deep dive into the SolidWorks Plastics simulation tool, and we will check how it will help you to design your plastic parts better without any defects. Finally, I'll take you through the summary and discuss few case studies. Now, plastics are everywhere. The mass use of plastics started in 1950s. And is steadily growing ever since. Today, more than 300 million tons of plastics are produced annually. The popularity of plastic is not due to its low production cost, but also its numerous practical characteristics, including low weight, acid resistance, and flexibility. Correct? So these are few of the important advantages that has made it much more popular as compared to the other metals, etc. In addition, plastic's flexible properties encourage technological innovations, particularly in the field of medicine, building technology, aircraft and auto, which leads to new solutions, improvements and comforts. So plastics, as I say, is not only just used in medical fields, but also in various fields like automobile industries, etc., because of its characteristics. Now, we'll just give you glimpses of this injection mold terminology. Before I actually take deep dive into the SolidWorks Plastics tool, I will just give you brief introduction, a very short introduction. What are its terminologies? Now, the injection molding consists of various parts, like there is a sprue. It is a passage from nozzle of injection molding machine to the mold runner system. So this is from where our molten plastic enters the runner system. The next step is the actual runner system. So this is the passage at the end of the sprue to the cavities. Correct. And finally, we have the gate location, that is ejection location. So it is interference between the runner system and the mold cavity. So by plastic, molten plastics enters from the sprue, then it goes through the runner system, and then it goes into the gate, and finally it enters into my mold cavity. And the last part, it fills up the cavity. Now, it is the form of the shape of the molded part. So this is the basic idea how the injection mold actually works. These are the major parts. Correct? So at the top, we can see there is a sprue, then there is a runner, then there is gate, and finally there is a cavity in which my plastic actually enters and gets solidified. So this is one more elaborated illustration of the terminologies that I have used, just to brush up your knowledge how everything is divided. Now moving ahead, why we choose ejection molding, right? What are its advantages and benefits? There are various manufacturing methods. If I talk about traditional, like milling, or we work on lathe machines, etc., right? Now why we go for ejection molding? What are its advantages? So the first and foremost important is, it produces complex geometry in net shape. So when I say net shape, means you get the finished product. There is no or very minimal we have to do it to get it completely finished, correct? So it is, we get the finished product directly. Very less amount of finishing work is to be done on the product. High volume, we can actually eject out thousands to millions of parts per year, correct? If we manufacture repetitive products, like in toys industry, in electronics industry, or in medical industry, where we manufacture single part, right? There is no need of any different product design, correct? So we can eject out thousands to millions of parts per year. So the volume of manufacturing is pretty high. Cycle time, the manufacturing process is fast. Typically it is between 3 seconds to, if the part is very huge, it can go up to a minute. Correct? Then low cost per part. Since we are manufacturing thousands and millions of parts, the cost of each part is very less as compared to the other manufacturing processes. So this is again one more advantage. Then we can manufacture detailed features and complex geometry, correct? With various ribs, fillets, chamfers. So the complex products can be manufactured, which could be very difficult to manufacture using traditional manufacturing processes. And finally, they are light in weight, they are chemically resistant, they have good strength to weight ratio. Correct? The weight of the plastics is very less, but again, they are also having strength. Correct? So the strength to weight ratio is also pretty good. So according to the applications, there are various types of plastics available which we can use for the particular application. So moving ahead, this is my machine overview, correct? So this is the simple schematic. From here, my plastic pellets, they will be going in the feed hopper. Here, the plastic pellets are melted. So there are heaters which are surrounded. And my ejection mold goes in here, the core and cavity. And finally, the plastic parts come out from here. So it is ejected here. Correct? Now this is my general schematic diagram of my molding machine, ejection molding machine. So this is pretty easy to understand, I guess. Right, now moving ahead, so there are various stages when the molten when the plastic is filled. It goes through various stages. The first stage, the screw moves forward and fills the mold cavity, correct? So next stage is, when the cavity is filled, we hold it, we keep the pressure for certain amount of time till it is 100% filled, right? And also we have to compensate shrinkage, right? So the second stage, pressure is released after the gate freezes, and molten plastic can no longer escape from the mold cavities. So we hold it for a certain amount of time. The next is the cooling stage. The plastic in the mold is cooled to a temperature that is safe for the part to be ejected out. That is when no deformation will occur. Correct? So these stages are very important. Any mismatch in timings, any mismatch in the pressure may result in your defective product. Correct? So once the cooling stage is completed, we eject the part. The mold opens and the cooled parts are ejected. And the cycle repeats for the next part. Now once we have understood what are the terminologies in the ejection molding machine, how it works, what are the benefits of plastics and what are the benefits of ejection molded parts, we have the next, that is why plastics we choose, like what are the benefits of this material. It is light in weight. As I am repeating, it is high strength to weight ratio. It can be easily customized. It can be molded into any shape. Correct? Almost limitless design flexibility. As you can see in your surrounding, it can be either mouse, it can be either remote, it can be either pen, it can be either your mobile case. So there are n number of parts that are surrounded there, which are made up of plastics. Correct? So that is the reason that the plastics are so important, and it is flexible. We can mold it into any shape and it can be used directly. Again, they are chemically inert and chemically resistant. So what does that mean? For example, food contact applications, right? Or medical devices or body parts, right? So these are the applications where there should be no reaction occurring to the material which we are storing inside the plastic. So if I talk about food contact applications, like the vessels in which we keep our food or in which we store the food, the plastic should not react with those chemicals, right? That is the reason it is used in such applications, including medical devices, body parts, right? Even hazardous waste storage, etc. It is chemically inert. That is also one of the main advantage why we choose this material for various applications. Again, it is having a good impact strength and it is visually aesthetic. Correct? So these are the few of the benefits, I can say, why we choose the plastics as the material for various applications, including food contact or medical devices, etc., and so on. Now the plastics are divided into two main categories: thermoplastics and thermosets. Now, as we all know, that thermosets, where they remain in the permanent stage, correct? And thermoplastics can be remelted back to liquid and it can be used again. So these are the two differentiating points in the plastic material. Again, if I talk about thermoplastics, they are again divided depending on its applications. They come in two types: amorphous and crystalline. Correct? So these are few of the plastic materials which are amorphous and few which are crystalline in nature. Now, why there are two types of categories in thermoplastics again? So it depends on the property that they have. Like if you want optical property, right? So it comes transparent in amorphous and it comes to be opaque or translucent in crystalline form. Then if you want light transmission, chemical resistance, if you want very good chemical resistance, you can go for crystalline, right? So according to the application of your end use, you can choose the type of plastic, correct? Now going ahead, just a little bit of more knowledge regarding to the effects of design material change on processability. When you increase your wall thickness, what will affect? Your pressure will go down, but cooling time will increase. So these are a few of the common things that might occur when you either increase the wall thickness, decrease the wall thickness, correct? If you increase the flow length, means if you change the gate location, it might affect in your pressure, right? If you add gates, if you add any colorant, if you add any reinforcements, so what will be the effect? So I have just listed down few of the common effects that might occur when you make the changes. Now why we have to analyze or do the analysis or use SolidWorks plastic software, correct? Because there are various defects coming when the plastic part is ejected out, like warpage, right? Then there is one more defect, that is air trap. So I have just listed down few of the defects which occur when the plastic part is ejected out. And to avoid these defects, there is the software available, right? So finally we will have a hands-on on the software. I'll show you how easily you can get rid of all these defects. Then there are few more defects like sink marks. There is weld lines, which are aesthetically not good. And also these defects will reduce the strength, reduce the life of the product. Then short shot might occur. The cavity may not get completely filled, right? And so on. So to get rid of all these defects and to manufacture our part which is perfectly correct, we use SolidWorks simulation to analyze the product first and then we manufacture it. Okay, now there are various unanswered questions, like when you design your product, you have various queries in your mind, whether it is manufacturable, right? What will be the best gate location, right? Will there be any air traps, weld lines? How many mold revisions I might have to do, right? So it is not very easy to design plastic products. You will have to actually get various parts ejected out from your ejection machine before you actually get the perfect part. So there are 2 revisions, 3 revisions, 4 revisions, right? You will have to make some minute changes to get your first correct plastic part. So these are various queries which might come in your mind. How about customer rejection due to visual or structural defects? How about quality, etc.? So using SolidWorks simulation to design better plastic parts. Now SolidWorks plastic delivers easy to use simulation for analyzing plastic part and ejection molds. It simulates how melted plastics flows during the ejection molding process to predict manufacturing related defects. So you can quickly evaluate part manufacturability while you design, correct? So simultaneously, when you design your product or you create 3D model of that, you can do the analysis. If there are any minute changes required, you can again come back to the 3D CAD, do the necessary changes, and again analyze, correct, till you get the perfect results, and then you can manufacture it using a rejection molding machine. Now let me take an example of this mokala. It is made up of two parts. One is the top component and another is the bottom component, correct? Both are made up of plastics and manufactured using rejection molding machine. So I'll just take you through how SolidWorks would help you in designing better plastic parts. Okay, so this is my component. So I have just created an exploded view. Now, as you all know, SolidWorks is the most user-friendly CAD tool, right? So I have just created the CAD modeling of this component and I have assembled it. Yes. So here is my feature history. Like, this is my casing. These are various components in it. Correct. Yeah, and these are few views that I have created. Now, as a smoke alarm, there are a few electronic components also inbuilt, right? Also, there is a snap hook, correct? There is a snap hook groove. So all the plastic manufacturing details that you require are all inbuilt in this. Now let me just open this component. Correct. Now we are also having this mold tool feature available, in which if you want to perform draft analysis to check whether draft is required or how much angle should I give so that there are no defects in it, right? It can be easily molded out. Now let me choose the face and let me change the angle. Yes, over here it will directly give you in color coding where is positive draft, where draft is required, it is in yellow color, and negative draft, right? So it can be easily molded out with 1 degree, so it gives you good visual appearance, correct? Now once your modeling is ready, we have various add-ins. So in single window itself, you can choose if you want to do your structural analysis, you want to do your CFD flow simulation, or you want to do your ejection molding and mold flow analysis, that is SolidWorks Plastic. So just by activating your add-in, you will get all your analysis features over here, correct? So you can begin your analysis. Like over here, I will go to the meshing. Yeah, over here. So you can start by dividing your part into number of elements that we call meshing, correct? And then you can give all the conditions, like where your gate location should be, how much your ejection pressure should be, right? Even you can add cooling lines, you can create runner system if required. So there are various inbuilt runner systems also included, so that I will take you through one by one. So in the meantime, if you have any query, you can just type it in the chat window, and at the end of the session, we'll just have a Q&A. So right now it is automatically meshing the part. So this is good time to check if there are any queries. Mr. Kishan, no, SolidWorks, in SolidWorks Premium, mold tools is available, but this plastics, what I'm showing you right now, plastic analysis, that is an add-on product. So the mold tools is available. If you want to check if there are any parting line analysis you want to do, correct? You want to check whether the core and cavity can be easily created or not, right? All those first-hand analysis can be done in your SolidWorks Premium tool, correct? But if you want to do the mold flow analysis, like how the molten plastic is flowing through the cavity, that can be done using this SolidWorks Plastics add-in. I'll just open the part. I think it is taking a longer time than what it should require. So just a second. Yeah, in the meantime, if anybody else is having any queries, you can type it in the chat window. Yes. Okay, moving ahead, I'll just activate the required configuration. Okay, and let me open the required part. Perfect. So over here I have created few configurations. Like the first configuration that I have created in this single part is, what if my thickness is 1 mm? So over here the thickness of this part is 1 mm, correct? And this is my plastics feature manager. We have over here CAD, that is 3D modeling feature manager, and just beside we have our SolidWorks Plastics feature manager also available. So once you have done your meshing, the next and foremost important thing is we will have to apply the material, correct? Now as we all know, SolidWorks is having inbuilt library of all the standard materials of metals, non-metals, etc. In the same way, SolidWorks Plastics is having the material library of all the standard plastics. You can either create user-defined material, or there is a default database according to the different criteria. Like if you want it to be as ABS, so there are again sub materials in ABS plus PA. You can even filter it according to the company. If in your company you are using 3M material, right? Or we are also having plastics of all these companies. See over here. So you can just filter out which company you use the material, and then it will give you the list of materials. Correct? So over here I am using the generic material PC polycarbonate, and it will list down all the properties. What is the viscosity, right? What are the material properties, like the melt temperature, mole temperature, right? What is the thermal conductivity, elastic modulus, Poisson's ratio, and so on. So the material properties are very illustratively provided over here. Correct? Once your material is given, you can also provide material of your mold. So all the metals are listed over here. What is the material of your mold? You can select it from here. Correct? And the important steps are listed here, that what will be the filling time. Correct? You can choose, or you can depend on the software suggested value of filling time. Correct? According to the part thickness and dimensions, the software will give you one default filling time, or else you can just rewrite it and provide your own filling time. Then there is melt temperature, ejection pressure limit, even clamping force, everything can be taken care of. Correct? Even you can give some pack settings, like what is the pressure holding time, what is the cooling time, etc. once the cavity is completely filled. And finally, if you are interested to check what is the warpage, you can specify the ambient temperature and the gravity direction, how your part would be oriented when it is ejected out. Correct? So you can specify the gravity direction also. Finally, let me provide the ejection location here. Correct? So you can provide the ejection location. I have provided in this area, or else you can add it automatically. So the software suggested values are also provided, right? But you can add the location as per your convenience also, as per manufacturability also. Correct? Finally, let me run the analysis and read the results. So I've already run the analysis and these are few results. Now we can see that the part is not getting completely filled. Correct? So it will show you graphically how the molten plastic is flowing within the cavity. Correct? As well as what is the pressure at the end, what is the temperature, right? Even if any sink marks are there. Ease of fill. Now what this will suggest you, whether my cavity is getting easily filled, right? Or there are few areas where it is incomplete filling. Like over here there is a warning message given that this area is not getting completely filled. Correct? So you can just go through the results and check everything, whether your part is getting completely filled or not. Now let me just change the thickness. You may notice I have created various configurations. So just by activating the configuration, all the necessary changes would be coming up. And when the configuration is changed, you will just have to run it once. Correct? All the parameters like the mesh, you will have to provide the mesh. Rest parameters like the the polymer material, the process parameters will remain same. Correct? Now with this improved thickness, let me check what will be the effect, whether it could completely fill or not. Okay, now it is giving me improved result. It is getting completely filled, right? To be sure, you can again go to your ease of fill option, which will guide you whether it is easily filling or not. Correct? Also, you can check the weld lines if they are occurring in your product. Correct? As well as air traps. So the location of air traps will be provided for your reference. Correct? Even volumetric shrinkage, if it is occurring in terms of percentage, will be shown. Cooling time and so on. Correct? Even shear stress will be displayed over here. Now, I want to change my gate location. What if I change the gate location and check if I'm getting any improved results or not? Right? So I have made one more configuration in which I have changed the gate location. Correct? So previously I had given my location here, but now I have changed it to here. So likewise, you can do various types of what if analysis, I would say. If you change your material, if you change your gate location, if you change the thickness of your part, right? Until you come to a final conclusion that this is my product without any errors in it. Correct? So over here, the pressure at the end of fill is I'm getting nearly 47 MPa, right? You can even bifurcate using shrinkages. Like over here, I'm getting 13.55% of shrinkage. Correct? And in the previous gate location where I have provided, let me show you the shrinkage. Yes, the location was here. It is 12%. Right? So depending on all these results, you can come to a conclusion which is the best parameters for your plastic part. Now what if I change the material? So right now it was polycarbonate PC, but I have just changed it to ABS plus PC in this part. Yeah, so over here, I will just open the database and this is my material, ABS plus PC. Correct? And then you can check the results. What is the fill time? What is the volumetric shrinkage? Again, the shrinkage has been reduced to certain extent, which will guide you to better design your plastic products. Correct? Now, what if you want to eject out multiple parts, right? Like over here, I have created four cavities. That is one set of smoke alarm. One is top casing, another is bottom casing. Likewise, there are two sets of fire alarms that I want to eject out. Also, I have created a runner system over here. So you can specify virtual runner design, right? So I've just created a 3D sketch and you can lay down your runner system over here. Correct? Just specify the diameters. Correct? And you can assign the values. And the material parameters and my ejection location will be right, will be here now, correct? And then let me just read the results. Now, one of the most important things when you are doing family mold or multiple cavity mold flow analysis, the most important thing is you will have to check whether runner balancing is done or not, whether all the cavities are getting filled at the same time or not, correct? If there is uneven filling of the cavity, then there will be uneven, uneven cooling time, right? So that may result in uneven shrinkage, warpage, etc. So as we can see here, the bottom casing of the fire alarm, right, are getting filled very late. They are getting filled at the very later stage of the time. So there is uneven filling. So that thing also can be eradicated. We are having the runner balancing inbuilt in this. So software will automatically balance the runner diameters, right, which will assist in balanced filling of the cavities. Correct. So this is my runner balancing feature. So over here you can specify the number of iterations. So you can see the diameters are different for each runner. Correct. So you can specify the maximum and minimum diameter of the runner and minimum and maximum diameter of the gate from where my molten plastic will be entering. Right. And software does a quick calculation and gives us balanced runner design. Correct. So up to certain extent you will try to achieve a good runner balancing. Now I can see over here that all the four cavities are getting filled at say same amount of time. Previously there was huge difference between the filling time of the cavities. So likewise you can run number of iterations till you achieve good results or good balanced runner system design. Correct. Now let me go on to the next set of analysis. Let me just close this. Yes. So over here I have applied cooling channels also. Correct. Just simple sketch is required for that. And virtually you can apply the cooling channels. Again, there is different materials of coolant included in the software. It can be either water or any type of refrigerant, etc. Correct. Now the procedure is same. I have applied my material. I have given various process parameters, what should be the filling time. I have even applied the pack settings. I will be holding it for 5 seconds, correct, and cooling time I have specified to be 18 seconds, as well as I want to check if there are any warpage. So I have provided the exact orientation of my component, how it will be oriented while it is manufactured, correct. And my ejection location is provided at this end. And now let me go through the results. Yeah, so over here, this is my filling time. So if you want to check the results after the packing stage, after the holding time, it will show you those results as well. How much will be the shrinkage after the packing? What will be the temperature, right? And so on. And you can check the warpage results also. Correct. Let me just change the deformation scale to 1. Yes, so we can see that the warpage I am getting is 0.8 mm at this location. So I will show you in a bit exaggerated results. I will change the deformation scale, and you can see it in the animated form also, that when it is ejected out of the cavity, how much warpage would occur. Correct? So you can take into account this error, and you can design your mold so that the warpage which you are getting is in your prescribed limits. Correct? You can change your pressure, you can change the material, you can change the orientation, and so on. Correct? And finally, you can just create the results. Like, let me just open the results. Yeah. I'll just extract the results from here. Yeah, summary and report. So you can generate your results either in MS Word or PowerPoint. Correct? So let me just generate it and hit OK. So yeah, so you can include what all things you require in your report, right? Introduction, any notes, any images if you want to be inserted. Right, so you can select the images accordingly, right, which images you require, and a template, in which template you want the report. And SolidWorks will just at the back end take all the videos, snapshots, right, and create a good report. So this is one benefit. It will also create directly in the PPT format. So in the meantime, if there are any queries, you can just type it in the chat window, right? So this is a good time, you can ask any queries till the reports are getting generated. And let me open the report. I'll open the PPT format. So this is the report. So it will have various content like introduction, information, what is material, information, process conditions, etc. Correct? So all the parameters that you have chosen will be coming up here automatically, including the material models, material properties, and so on, and the results of each and every result, temperature, pressure, and so on. Correct? The same goes for your Word. So this is my report. It will have all the necessary information. Correct? Even in HTML format, yeah, you will get your report. So if you want to directly check it over your browser, so this is much more interactive. You can just click in the required region, the required index, it will directly take you there. Correct? And the results. These are the warpage results. So this is much more interactive way of checking the results. Correct? So in Word, PPT, or in HTML, you can check your results. So finally, the benefits, like you can cover wide range of ejection molding processes, you can predict manufacturing related defects on parts and molds, you can do part design, you can do gate design, runner design, even cooling system design can be done, right? And important, you can avoid expensive mold rework, right? And which results in reduced time to market and reduced material wastage, resulting in again healthy environment. So one case study that I would like to mention is this Ambix Consultants LLC, which manufactures consumer products like goggles, helmets, chairs, etc. So the challenge that they faced was streamlining complex ejection mold development to improve manufacturability, shorten development time, reduce cost. So these are the common challenges that face, that many industries face nowadays. So with the help, by implementing SolidWorks Plastics, they were able to cut mold development time, achieve a good first shot success on the molds, increase annual molded output, right, from few thousands to million parts, right, and realize close correlation between simulations and productions. Now I would like to conclude my webinar by saying that if you have any queries, you can visit our site or reach out to us, correct? And now I am open to any questions if you have any. So you can type it in the chat window. I will answer those. Thank you everybody for your time. I hope I was able to give you a good presentation, a good knowledge about the mold, as well as how SolidWorks Plastics would help you in designing and manufacturing the parts without any defects. Thank you.